why do so many Africans now prefer to spell Africa as A-F-R-I-K-A with a K rather than A-F-R-I-C-A with a C? I am Eze Chimere Nwauzo. I'm an author of The Wisdom and the Power of African Unity, author of 202 Questions and Answers About African Progress. I'm the leader of One Africa Family OAF, and our vision is to lead Africans from last to first. Why do so many Africans now prefer to spell Africa as A-F-R-I-K-A with a K rather than A-F-R-I-C-A with a C? Are we supposed to spell Africa as A-F-R-I-K-A with a K or A-F-R-I-C-A with a C? If we're supposed to spell Africa with K, then why? Or with a C, then why? If not, then why not? Now here are the answers. In the Igbo language spoken in Nigeria, Equatorial Guinea, and Gabon, the spelling of Africa is spelled as A-F-R-I-K-A. In the Yoruba language spoken in Western Nigeria, Togo, and Benin Republic, the spelling of Africa is A-F-R-I-K-A, or sometimes A-F-I-R-I-K-A. In Zulu and Xhosa languages spoken in the southern part of Africa, the spelling of Africa is A-F-R-I-K-A. In the Somalian language, or the Somali language spoken in the Horn of Africa, in the nation of Somalia, in the Horn of Africa, it is spelled A-F-R-I-K-A. In most of the indigenous languages spoken in Africa, the spelling of Africa is A-F-R-I-K-A. Now, are we supposed to spell Africa now with A-F-R-I-K-A or A-F-R-I-C-A? If Africa belongs to the Europeans, who spell Africa as A-F-R-I-C-A, especially in the English language, then the spelling of Africa should remain A-F-R-I-C-A. But if the African continent belongs to Africans, who spell Africa as A-F-R-I-K-A, then the spelling of Africa should now be permanently A-F-R-I-K-A. Secondly, Africans should spell Africa as A-F-R-I-K-A to regain the lost respect of Africa. As Africans, we are the ones who should decide the spelling of our continent and the spelling of every single place in Africa. Now take for example, in California, the third largest city in California is San Jose. San Jose was founded September 29, 1777 by Spanish colonizers in America. They named the city San Jose. Now if you look at the name San Jose, S-A-N-J-O-S-E, you call it San Jose. But did you know that actually the pronunciation is San Jose or San Jose? Till today in America, the city is known as San Jose because in Spanish, J is pronounced as H. Why did the English people, even though they are now the ones who control America, why did they not change the name from San Jose, the spelling, to San Jose, instead of with J, to spell it with H, to reflect the English spelling now used? They left it as it is in the Spanish language to show respect to the Spanish people, but they did not show the same respect to Africans. For example, Accra in Ghana. Accra in Ghana should be A-K-R-A or A-K-A-R-A, Accra. Now they call it A-C-C-R-A, Accra, which in African language is meaningless. The same thing they did in Igbo cities. For example, we have Enugu, a city in southeast of Nigeria, should be E-N-U-G-W, Enugu, changed to Enugu, which does not have any meaning in Igbo language. They did the same by renaming some ancient landmarks in Africa. For example, the Lake Nyanza in southeastern Africa has been renamed long time ago to Lake Victoria. This is how the Europeans keep asserting their influences on African landmarks and changing the names in Africa to their own reflections. So, if we Africans want to show that we want to regain the respect that the Europeans took from us, one of the ways to regain it is by making sure that we spell Africa with a K, and to make sure that we regain the other names they took from us. Even in Igbo language, there was a time they used to call the Igbos as the Igbos, I-B-O, or I-B-O-S. But the Igbo people refused and retain the original name IGBO, which is what we still bear to today. That is to show that we cannot allow the Europeans to tell us how to spell our own name. Thirdly, we spell Africa with a K to regain our past history, to reconnect with our past history. For example, the original name Africa is an African name. Although some people say that the name Africa came through Scipio Africanus, a European Roman general, but actually the name Scipio Africanus is a nickname. Africanus means the African. So the name Scipio Africanus actually means Scipio of Africa, or Scipio the African. The original name of Scipio Africanus is Publius Cornelius Scipio. He gained the nickname Scipio Africanus in the year 202 BC after he defeated Hannibal, the greatest African general and the greatest general in the history of the world, in the Battle of Zama in the year 202 BC in the Second Punic War, fought in present-day Tunisia. When he returned back to Rome, they began to hail him and gave him the nickname Scipio Africanus. Scipio Africanus means that the name Africa had been in existence before 202 BC and before the Romans. Also, according to Professor of African Studies, Ivan Van Stetteman, who lived from the year 1935 to the year 2009, a Guyanese African who was an Associate Professor of African Studies in the University of America, author of They Came Before Columbus, who wrote about how Africans were in America before Columbus. He talked about in the year 1311 AD, how Mansa Boubacar, the king of Mali, the Malian Empire, left Africa in the year 1311 AD and made his way into Mexico, and how the Mexicans received him as Quetzalcoatl, their sun god. He also wrote about how the Olmecs were in Southern America before the Mayans and the Aztecs. According to him, the name Africa is an original name of the African continent, gotten from the name Afro-Ica, from Egyptian language, ancient Egyptian language. And Afro means to return to, then Ka, birthplace, spirit. So Africa, according to him, means birthplace. And it's spelled actually A-F-R-U-I-K-A, and not with a C. So Africa actually means birthplace, origin, which is why Africans are the original people, and the African continent is the original continent where human beings began to spread and spread the world, and also where civilization began and spread across the world. So when you spell Africa with a K, you are reconnecting back to the original ancestral spelling of Africa. Also, there is a pharaoh, a fourth dynasty pharaoh, who is known as Pharaoh Khafre. Pharaoh Khafre is one of the builders of the Great Pyramids of Giza. At Giza, there are three main pyramids. One, the pyramid of Khufu. Two, the pyramid of Khafre, his son, and the pyramid of Menkaure. The second pyramid of all of them was built by Pharaoh Khafre. And if you turn his name from Khafre to the other way around, you have Pharaoh Africa, meaning that Africa is actually an indigenous African name for the African continent. And when you spell it with a K, that's where you can now begin to reconnect it back to the African history. But when you spell it with a C, you're actually spelling another African another continent altogether, a continent owned by the Europeans, which is what we have been seeing all the while. Some say it doesn't matter. Spell it with a K, spell it with a C, it's still the same Africa, it does not matter. We need food, we need water, we need all these things. And that's the same mentality that gave us the fake independence that we have now. That's the same mentality that made our founding fathers, or the nationalists, to go for political independence only and forget about other aspects or facets of independence. They went for flags, seats in the United Nations to have physical representation, as they are the ones leading Africa, whereas the real political power comes from Britain, comes from France, comes from Lisbon, and so on. They gave us fake independence. In fact, what they gave us is not even political independence. They gave us physical independence, where we see physical things to represent independence. We see a physical flag, we see a physical human being, giving us the impression that we're actually ruling ourselves, whereas we know that we are not the ones ruling ourselves. We still pay colonial debts, colonial taxes. Over 14 African countries have to pay billions of dollars to France annually. Britain controls about $1 trillion worth of natural resources in Africa. But Africa is independent. It is these little things that we neglect that become big when we neglect them. if we cannot address something as little as changing the name of Africa from Africa to Africa, then how are we going to challenge those who were paying colonial system? That is the reason why we still have education in Africa that produce people who cannot cater for themselves. We have education in Africa, but we cannot industrialize Africa. We still export our raw materials. We don't know that is neocolonialism. We have to break away everything that has to do with neocolonialism in Africa. And spelling Africa with a K is one of the greatest messages we can send to the Europeans that it is time for total independence in Africa. And we're not going to be like the former or nationalist who went for only fiscal independence and left out the economy of Africa, left out political independence, and left us in the situation that we found ourselves. So, if Africa wants to prove that Africa belongs to Africans, we spell Africa with a K. If Africans want to regain the respect that other nations are given, then we have to spell Africa with a K to assert that we have respect as human beings and we are not supposed to be under the domination of others. Three, if we want to reconnect back to our ancient history, that Africa is the ancestral land of all human beings on earth and is the origin of civilization, then Africa is Africa. If we want to prove that we are ready for complete independence, total freedom, and not half colonization, half independence, in the end, we don't have anything to show for, then let us change the spelling of Africa from Africa to Africa, which is the real spelling of Africa. God bless Africa. Share the video. Let us all begin the African movement.